Spotlight presents. Part 1 of a 3-part video series. In today's video, I will discuss the first 3 limitations of science and the scientific method in layman's terms. The term science is derived from the Latin word scientia, which means knowledge. The American Dictionary defines science as the systematic study of the structure and behavior of the natural and physical world. The scientific method involves experimental attempts to understand and explain the principles and forces working in the natural universe through A. Observation. B. Formulating hypothesis about the observation. C. Experiment and data gathering. D. Conclusion, reporting and evaluating findings. The boundary between science and pseudoscience is usually not distinct and sharp. There are those who misconstrue science as solving, or in the process of solving, all phenomena, and therefore transforming it into a sort of religion of our era. Where once priests were expected to provide insight into the nature of the cosmos and of human existence, now we look rather to scientists to explain all these stuff to us. There is the mistaken concept that no religious or spiritual beliefs could possibly have any validity, since modern scientific methods have successfully explained or disproven these beliefs. In the following sections, I will attempt to show that science as traditionally conceived has serious limitations in its ability to answer some of the most profound and fundamental questions on the nature of existence. The limits of science are defined by limits imposed on empirical evidence accessible through measurement and experiment. In this part 1 of a 3-part video series, I am analyzing the first 2 of the top 10 limitations of science. Limitation number 1. Scientific observations are based on the 5 human senses. Scientific investigations are carried out by human beings, scientists, as the fundamental instrument of observation. They utilize the 5 senses of sight, smell, touch, taste, and hearing. In addition, humans use invented instruments such as the telescope, optical and electron microscopes, cyclotron, and many more modern tools of observation to enhance and/or extend the 5 senses. These observations of nature can be generalized to other conscious beings in their environments, such as animals, fishes, birds, and bacteria. Based on its fundamental definition and conceptualization, science is not equipped to observe and analyze the nature of the observer that is doing this observation. The observer behind these instruments of observation is far beyond the grasp of the limited observational tools. Limitation number 2. Transcendence of the observer beyond science and the scientific method. Science and the scientific method are not equipped to observe the observer, or what may be called the source or creator of the universe. Ideas about creator or God and other supernatural beings may never be confirmed or denied scientifically, since experiment does not exist that could test their validity. Consequently, we cannot accept nor reject such hypothesis. Therefore, the positions taken by believers, theist, and non-believers, atheist, are equally scientifically untenable, since there is no possible scientific proof for the presence or absence of a creator or supreme being. That there is indeed a limit upon science is made very likely by the existence of questions that science cannot answer, and that no conceivable advance of science would empower it to answer. That is why there is a growing interest in merging modern science with ancient Eastern wisdom or thought, which deals extensively with consciousness or the inner space, as opposed to the outer space, which is the realm of science. Niels Bohr articulated this interest well in the following statement: "We must turn to those epistemological problems with which thinkers such as Jesus, the Buddha, and Lao Tzu have been confronted when trying to harmonize our position as spectators and actors in the great drama of existence." This brings us to the end of part 1 of this series of videos. Please subscribe to this channel and look out for part 2, which will be posted soon.